Hello and welcome to this lecture. Today we are going to discuss an important topic to discuss about how a drug works. So suppose, for example, if you are having a fever and you need to take medicine, did you ever realize that what happened when you take the medicine? And I know that most of the students that don't know that what happened to the drug when they take it into the body. Even did you ever realize that when you eat the food, what happened to that food? So my answer is that nobody has realized that what you eat, what you take, what will be the effect of that in your body. So today we are going to discuss this thing. So the main thing when we talk about, even we're talking about the food or we're talking about a drug have to be processed going inside the body, and there are some mechanism that will occur in your body. So we explain in terms of this small abbreviation that I make, which is ADME. A for absorption, D for distribution, M for metabolism, and E stand for elimination. And if you take a look of this picture, that this is a medicine. So what happens when you take from mouth and it goes inside to your esophagus and reach into the stomach? So this is the side of the stomach, and what happened? The drug have to be absorbed first. So how it will be absorbed? The first thing is that drug, when enter into the body, it go and enter into the stomach and disintegrate first. What is meant by disintegration? Disintegration means to break. And it's just like a similar mechanism that one, when you take the food, you swallow the food, and then food will be broken down into small pieces. Why? Because you cannot digest the whole clump or whole plug of one food. The food need to be broken down into the small molecules so that you get the energy. Same like the medicine, that when you take medicine and that medicine goes into your stomach contains different enzymes. Or in simple word, digestive enzymes. And that digestive enzyme is responsible not only to break the food, but also responsible to break or disintegrate the medicine. And then what happened after disintegration? Some of the medicine have to be absorbed either through the stomach or then it reach through the intestine. Like you see, this is medicine. It goes into the stomach, as you see, and then it will absorb into the intestine. How it will be absorbed? With the help of blood. So the drug that you take orally have to be absorbed first. How it will be absorbed? Through either stomach or through intestine. This is the first stage. Then what happened? I mentioned here in the distribution where it will go. So what happened that when the drug has been absorbed, the drug have to be distributed throughout the body, like these arrows are showing to you. So it can reach to your brain. It could reach to your peripherals. It could reach to your all tissues. So blood is the medium which is responsible to carry the drug through different tissues or different organs. So the blood is the medium that carry the drug. So that is why this is very important. Why distribution is important? Because I discussed last time as well that how you take the drug is very important. If you take the medicine orally, like in this case, we're talking about principle of pharmacokinetics, which means that how absorption, distribution, metabolism, and elimination occur. What happened? So you have to understand that, for example, if you take the drug orally, there is a long process of getting the drug in your blood, because blood is the carrier that is responsible to carry that source or carry the drug not only to your hands, to your organs, but also to your brain. And some are psychogenic drugs that have psychotic properties. So how it reaches to your brain when you're taking from mouth, that's a very question that is very important. So my answer is that brain is an important part, and the blood is the medium that is responsible to carry that drug from your mouth to your brain. And that is why I discussed last time that the oral route, or if you take that drug direct intravenous through your veins, the effect or the response of the effect will be different. So suppose when you take the drug through orally, the drug have to be absorbed, but it goes into your esophagus, then reach to your stomach, and then absorption occur, and after absorption it reaches to your brain, which needs a lot of time. But when you take a drug directly to your veins like here, then the drug directly reaches to your all body parts, and that's why the process becomes shortened and the effect will be very fast. So the first stage is absorption, then it will be distribution, then the third stage is a metabolism. And in the metabolism, the drug metabolizes in the liver. Liver is the site for drug metabolism, and the drug metabolism is responsible for small fraction of the drug that reaches to your blood. Because what will happen, that the drug sometime it have to be go through transformation, and that transformation is actually very important. And that transformation actually occur in the liver, where the drug actually, we discussed that before as well, that what is actually a drug. Drug is actually a chemical, and it could be either natural, it could be either semi-synthetic, or it could be synthetic, we discussed before. So what happened, that sometime when you take the drug is not active. I mean, in some time there are different classification of drugs. I'm not going to discuss that in this class. But what happened, there are some drugs that initially they are not active. And then later on, but when it reaches to your liver in this side, it transforms into active metabolite or inactive chemical that is responsible for producing the effect when it reaches into the system. So you have to understand that the drug have to be metabolized sometime, and then the last is excretion. But whatever you eat, even whatever you take the drug have to be eliminated in the form of feces, and then all the waste matter have been eliminated through excretion. So that's how a drug will work. Although this the pharmacokinetics or how drug work, it is a very detailed and lengthy long process, and a lot of terminologies and chemistries involved. But I know that in my class there are not a lot of students that are familiar with the chemistry, so I'm not going to explain in detail. But in generally, you must need to understand that the drug will be work with the process known as pharmacokinetics. That pharmacokinetics have four parts: A, D, M, E. You can memorize with the word ADAM: A for absorption, D for distribution, M for metabolism, E for elimination. And every step has its own value. Thank you so much for today's lecture. Hope to see you again.